Hello, welcome back. So in the previous part, we were at step two, where we were having general arrangement. So as per general arrangement, we have the effective span as 4980. So now in the next step, we will estimate the waste slab thickness. So as I have mentioned in the previous part, that generally in case of simple, we consider the slab design as a simply supported slab, and for that the thickness of the slab can be taken as L by 20. So as per thumb rule, it is L by 20. So L we have already calculated, which is the effective span divided by 20. So with this we get the thickness of waste slab as 249 mm, say 250 mm. So this is the thickness that we got with this thumb rule. We will check this thickness later also. So now this is basically the overall depth. We have found the overall depth. So we also require to find out D provided, and for that we have to assume the clear cover. So because in the question it is being mentioned that moderate exposure is given. So if you refer to the table 16, so for moderate exposure we can have clear cover as 20 mm, and to calculate the effective depth we also require. So we will also assume the die off bar to calculate the effective depth. So we are assuming that the die off bar that we will be using will be 12 mm dia. So with this we can calculate the effective depth, which is overall depth minus clear cover minus half of the die off bar, and the value of D provided is 224. So as per step three, we will be providing depth, but before we approve it, we have to check whether this depth is okay or not. So we will be checking that by calculating the maximum bending moment, and maximum bending moment will be dependent on the load calculation. So first of all, we have to calculate the load on our steps. Also, this is the depth that we have assumed for our this flight stair slab. So in this case you can see in the flight there are steps, which means there will be more load on the flight slab rather than, I mean, as compared to the slab of landing. So therefore what we can do is, for to make this design economically viable, what we can do is we can reduce the thickness of landing slab, and therefore I have assumed that thickness of landing slab may be taken as say 200 mm. Okay, so now we will move to our next step, which is the load calculation. Now in this case again we will be finding load on as dead load and live load. So as I have explained earlier, that the thickness of this slab will be 250 mm, and we have assumed that thickness of this landing slab will be 200 mm. So therefore first of all we will find out how much load is there on this waste slab. Okay, so first we will find out the load on the waste slab, and after that we will find out the load on the landing slab. So first in the waste slab there will be two load, one is dead load and the live load. So first of all we will calculate the dead load, and in the dead load there will be load self weight of waste slab, self weight of steps, floor finishing weight. So all these load we have to calculate, but before we calculate we have to understand the concept how we are going to calculate load in this case. As you can see, our slab will be like this. This is our landing. Okay, so we are now supposed to calculate load on this slab, and the steps are something like this. So they are something like this. So this time, because we are designing the whole slab, what we can do is we will actually be calculating load on unit area by considering the unit strip as we have done in case of two-way slab design. So in this case, what we do is, if this is the waste slab, so what I am doing, why I will consider it as, first one will be the waste slab, and on this waste slab there are steps which are in the triangular form, which are in the triangular form like this. So what I am doing is, I will consider this triangle as a rectangle. So that rectangle will something look like this, and this rectangle will have thickness equals to r by 2. So this r by 2 is the, as you can see, this is r and this is 0. So the average, I mean this area, can be calculated as rectangle having r by 2 thickness and this value as t. So this is how we are going to consider here. So this time my slab will be, one will be the waste slab, and above there will be a layer of steps which I have considered uniformly. So this time the load will be at the unit area. I will be finding load at unit area, 1 meter by 1 meter area. So like we have considered unit strip in two-way slab design, in the same way I will be considering unit strip here in this case also, and therefore I will be finding load on a unit area. So that is the concept here that I am going to use. So first will be the self weight of the waste slab. So self weight will be equals to volume of waste slab multiplied by the density. So volume will be 1 into 1 is the unit area multiplied by the thickness. Thickness will be 0.25 meter, which is 250 mm that we have assumed in the previous step, multiplied by the 25. So that is the load when slab is horizontal, but our slab is inclined. So I have to multiply this with the cos theta, and cos theta is basically, I have explained in the previous numerical also, so that cos theta will be around, if this is t, this is r, and this is b, and this is theta. So theta will be b by t. So b will be 292, because this b can be calculated by using the Pythagoras theorem. If we know the value of t and r, we can calculate the value of b by using the Pythagoras theorem. So that is why I will multiply this with this, because I am calculating the load normal to the slab. So that is what I have done in the previous numerical also, where I have calculated the cos theta. So the same process I will be doing here. So 25 multiplied by 1 into 1 multiplied by 2.25 and multiply by the cos theta, and that we get 7.30 kilonewton per meter square. So that is the self weight of waste slab per unit area. Similarly, I will find out the self weight of steps. So as I have shown you that there will be a layer of steps having thickness r by 2 for unit area. The weight will be 1 into 1 into r by 2 multiplied by the density of RCC. Because I am designing this, I am considering these steps as RCC steps. So that is why I will multiply this with the 25. So 25 multiplied by r by 2 will be the weight of the self weight of the steps. So that is 1.88 kilonewton per meter square. Then the floor finishing is already mentioned, that 0.6 kilonewton per meter square. So I am supposed to find out load per meter square. So this is already given. So that is why I am taking this value as it is, that is 0.60 kilonewton per meter square. Now, in case of live load, it is also given, which is 4 kilonewton per meter square. So I am taking this as it is. Now, totaling the load. So load on the stair slab or on the flight, it is 13.78 kilonewton per meter square. So that is the total load on the waste slab. Similarly, we will find out the load on the landing also. So in case of landing, I am talking about this portion now. So this portion will something look like this. So I will be calculating load on this. And here also I will be finding load on unit area, because this is again a slab, which is landing slab. So in this case, now we will calculate the self weight of the slab as 1 into 1 into 0.2. That is the overall thickness of the landing slab multiplied by the 25. So that is the value here. And calculating this, we get the value as 5 kilonewton per meter square. There is no steps, so step load will not be calculated. Only the floor finishing will be there. So finishing load is already given, which is 0.6 kilonewton per meter square. Live load will also come on the landing, and that will be 4 kilonewton per meter square. So adding all the load, the load on the landing will be 9.60 kilonewton per meter square. So now this load distribution can be shown here also. So on this portion, this is the landing portion, the load is 9.60, and in between this portion, the load is 13.78 that we have calculated on the previous slide. And here also the load will be same, which is 9.60. So basically the loading diagram becomes like, look like this. So here you can see the load which is coming on the slab, it is not uniform. For one portion it is 13.78, and for the other two portion it is same 9.60 kilonewton per meter square. So therefore now we will calculate the maximum bending moment. And maximum bending moment will not be calculated by simply using WL square by 8, because in this case UDL is not uniform throughout. So therefore we have to actually calculate bending moment here. So also, as you can see, I have simply generalized this. This is basically like this. So bending will be occurring like this. So maximum bending moment, you can see it will be somewhere here near the midspan. And similarly here also, bending moment will occur at the midspan. We are assuming that it will occur at the midspan. So we have to calculate bending moment at this midspan. So before that, we have to find out what will be the reaction R1 and R2 developing because of this load. So as you can see, on half portion of the beam, the load is 9.60 and 3.78, and for the remaining half, the load is same, which means load is symmetric. So therefore reaction R1 and R2 will be same, which will be equals to total load divided by 2. So that is what I am doing here. Reaction at each support, it will be equal at both support as the load is symmetric, and therefore load at each reaction will be 9.60 into 1.36. You can see this load multiplied by the length, then this load multiplied by half of the length, because half load will be carried by reaction R1 and half load will be carried by reaction R2. So here I am calculating only the half load, and that is equals to the value of 26.465 kilonewton. So this is the reaction calculation. Now after this reaction, we will be calculating the bending moment. So as I said, bending moment will occur at the midspan. So the distance midspan from here, this distance will be 2.49 meter, and the overall distance is 4.98 meter. So now bending moment will be calculated here, which is reaction will create clockwise moment, sagging moment, which means 26.465 multiplied by the distance 2.49. If you don't know how to calculate bending moment, you can refer to the lecture structural mechanics internal forces, that is bending moment and shear force. So you can refer to that lecture to learn how to find out bending moment in the beam. So I am here calculating directly. So reaction moment due to reaction will be sagging. So this multiplied by, sorry, now this is the sagging moment because of the reaction. Similarly, moment due to this load will be, because you can see this will create hogging. So minus 9.60 multiplied by 1.365 multiplied by, it will act at mid of this distance. So this distance will be 2.49 multiplied by 1.365 divided by 2. Okay. Similarly, the moment due to this force. So this force will also create the hogging. So therefore, minus 13.78 multiplied by the length 2.25 by 2, because we are calculating bending moment at this point. So distance here will be 2.25 divided by 2 multiplied by where it will act. It will act at the at this point. So distance between this and this will be 2.25 divided by 4. So now calculating this value, we will get the maximum bending moment. So that is calculated here, and the value is 33.59 kilonewton meter. So that is the maximum bending moment that we are calculating, and the bending moment diagram will be shown here. So this is the bending moment diagram. There will be zero moment at this point, and at the landing you can see there will be less value of the moment here also, reference to this. So less value of the bending, maximum bending moment will occur in at this point, which is 33.59. so this is the maximum bending moment. And for this bending moment, we have to find out the, I mean, we have to check the thickness of waste slab. So thickness of waste slab can be checked by using the formula that we generally use to find out the D required and putting the value. M value is already known here because we are designing as a unit strip for the stair slab. So B value will be here 1000 mm, and R value will be 0.91, and this is our bending moment that we have just calculated. So the D required or the thickness required is 192.12, while you can see the effective depth in the stair slab we have taken as 224 in step 2, which means our D provided is sufficient. So thickness of waste slab is okay. So once the thickness is okay, we will move to the next step, which is the reinforcement calculation. So here reinforcement will be calculated into the two form. One will be the main reinforcement, which will be laid along the stair flight. So along the direction of going, we will be laying the main reinforcement to resist the bending moment, and the reinforcement parallel to the steps will be considered as the distribution reinforcement. So you can see this is exactly opposite to the reinforcement we have provided in the previous numerical. In the previous numerical, we used to provide main reinforcement along the steps and distribution reinforcement along the flight. So here we are doing opposite. Main reinforcement is providing along the flight, and distribution will be provided parallel to the steps. So now first we will calculate the main reinforcement. So for main reinforcement, we will find out the AST, and we know what is the formula for AST. MX, sorry, it is not MX, M max, it is actually M max. So M max upon sigma ST into D provided. It is basically D provided. So putting all the values here, we get the value of AST as 721.22 mm square. So this area will be provided in the number of bars. So here in this case, we will actually finding the spacing. So for the spacing, we have to assume the die of bar, but we have already assumed the die of bar in step two. So the same die of bar we will be using, that is 12 mm die. So the spacing can be calculated by this relation, and putting the value here, pi d square by 4, d here is 12 mm dia, and 1000 divided by AST that we have just calculated, the spacing comes out as 156.73 mm. So this is the spacing that we are supposed to provide. But before this, we will check whether it is less than the recommended value of IS code as per clause 26.3.3. So as per this clause, the spacing of main reinforcement should be the least of calculated value. One is 156.73. The second one is 3 times of the effective thickness. So effective thickness is D provided, that is 224. So 3 times of 224 is 672. And the third value is 300 mm. So you can see from both these two value, our calculated value is less than this. So we will be providing this thickness, this spacing. So we will round off this spacing to the lower side so that we can have AST provided more than required. So we will be providing the bottom layer reinforcement as 12 mm dia at the rate of 150 center to center. So this is the calculation of main reinforcement. Now we will be doing the calculation for distribution reinforcement also. So as per distribution reinforcement, we generally take 0.12% of the total cross-sectional area when HYSD bar is used. So using the relation, we can find out AST distribution, which is 300 mm square. So we have to distribute this area into the number of bars by calculating the spacing. So now we will find out the spacing. Now, before we calculate the spacing, we have to assume the dia of distribution bar. So either we take 8 mm dia, 10 mm dia, or 12 mm dia, it is completely up to us. But we need to take care of the fact that the dia of distribution bar can be equal to main bar or less than the dia of main bar. It will never be more than the dia of main bar. Okay. So here, our main bar dia is 12 mm. So we are taking the lesser value of distribution bar, or we can adopt 12 mm dia bar also. So but here in our case, we are adopting 10 mm dia bar, and based on this dia of bar, we will find out the spacing, and spacing with this the same relation, and putting all the value, the spacing comes out as 261.67. We will check this spacing with the IS code recommendations. So IS code recommendation is it should be the least of these three value. One is 261.67, that is the calculated value. And the second is 5 times of effective thickness, that is 5 times of D provided. So that is 1120. And the third one is 450 mm. So that is our third value. So you can see this calculated value is less than both of these value. So now we will provide this spacing as 260 mm center to center, 10 mm dia at the rate of 260 center to center. So that is our second reinforcement. Now, beside this, we will provide some extra reinforcement also at the junction. As I have mentioned earlier, that we will be providing some extra reinforcement to avoid the effect of negative bending moment. So for that, I will be showing you details of reinforcement bar on the next slide. But before that, we have to provide nominal reinforcement, which is 50% of the AST as 12 mm dia, 300 mm center to center provided in the landing slab. I will show you that in the next slide. And also I have mentioned that we generally provide some extra reinforcement at the junction. At this junction and at this junction, there may be a chances that negative bending moment may develop. So to avoid that, what we do is we provide some extra reinforcement. So those extra reinforcement will be in the form of AST and distribution bar. So AST will be 50% of the AST that we have provided at the mid span. So 50% will be 12 mm dia at 300 center to center. Similarly, distribution bar will also be provided, which is 10 mm dia at the rate of 260 center to center. So now I will be showing you the reinforcement details. So the same sketch we have used earlier to understand how reinforcement is being provided. So in this, you can see this is the main reinforcement, and that is 12 mm dia at the rate of 150 center to center. Similarly, now you can see this is the extra reinforcement I am talking about. This is the extra reinforcement as distribution bar. Similarly, this one bar is also extra reinforcement, 50% of the extra reinforcement. So which is, I think it should be 300. It should be 300 center to center. And here also these dots that you are seeing, these are the distribution reinforcement. So for one flight, the reinforcement detail is this one. And for the flight at ground floor, it will something look like this. So this part we have not designed, but I have shown so that you understand that how we connect the lower portion. So here also we have provided some extra reinforcement, and this extra reinforcement is 12 dia at the rate of 300 center to center. And these dots are basically the distribution reinforcement. These are also distribution, sorry, this one is basically the main reinforcement. We provide some chairs also to maintain the gap between the top and bottom layer. So we have provided chairs also. And reinforcement detail of that steps are also shown. Although we have not calculated these bar, but generally these are basically the 8 mm dia bar. And this is also 8 mm dia bar. And this we generally provide so that nosing can be protected. If we don't provide reinforcement, then this nosing may break up. So that is the reinforcement sketch. So that is the solution. Thank you.